episode of Parlor Games, where we focus on introducing other fans who carry out initiatives that help to further Prince's work and legacy. I am Shockadelica, and today I am very, very happy to welcome an amazing artist whose prints and designs are very, very well known in the Purple community. So let's welcome Marco Hart, also known as 1999 Art. Hello, Marco.
Hello. Thank you for having me. Yeah.
It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. I'm particularly happy, Marco, to finally speak face to face with you as we have been chatting for some months now. Mm-hmm. Since I invited you to participate in our last magazine, which was a parade monographic.
Yeah. Thank you. It's beautiful.
Yeah, and well, it includes one of your beautiful prints artwork. So thank you. Thank you very much from the bottom of my heart.
You're welcome.
And Marco, you are also attending our event, Get Off 2023.
I am.
Which is celebrated next month in Madrid, something that makes me really happy too.
That's good. I'm glad I can be there. I mean, I don't know many people in Spain, so it's good to learn, to get to know new people.
It's going to be fun. You will see. You will see.
Yeah, cool.
Okay, so Marco, I'm sure that most of the people watching this already know you and your work, but just in case, could you please tell the people who you are and how did you become 1999?
Okay. Obviously, I'm Marco, 53, from the Netherlands. And actually, I became 1999 after Prince left us. I go to Minneapolis in April 2017 for the first anniversary. But I didn't have the money, so I thought, well, I'm creative, so maybe I can use my creativity to raise a little money, and it works. I made a few postcards and t-shirts initially. Maybe you've seen these. These are the first cards I made.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the first, and I could sell enough to pay part of the trip. So that's how it happened actually. And during that trip, there was a contest for fans to make prints art, and I was one of the five lucky winners. And of course, there was huge motivation to continue this work. Yeah, so that's how it happened.
Okay, but before that, how did you start drawing?
I've been drawing since I was 4 or 5 years old.
Okay.
And then I left regular school and I went to art school and art academy. Mm-hmm. So it's somewhere in my blood, I guess.
So you are a very creative person and you mm-hmm. like drawing, and did you work on this type of tasks or areas before becoming 1999?
No, actually no. Mm-hmm. You know, with the Prince portraits, first one actually happened by accident.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was trying to make a Prince portrait, and you know, his face is so perfect and it's so easy to make mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't get the eyes right, I couldn't get the nose right, I couldn't get the mouth right. So I decided to
to the lady. It's very intelligent because they work really well.
It does. And actually, so that's how it that's how I got to do faceless and images.
Yeah, I know some people who also draw and paint, and whenever they try to draw or paint prints, they find really difficult to make their eyes. The eyes are like the most difficult part to portray in prints.
True. Mm-hmm. In any place, actually, but princess especially.
Yeah. And how would you describe your art, Marco?
I would say minimalist. I'm a graphic designer and I love designing logos. And now when I make a portrait, I try to treat it like a logo. You know, the less details is better.
Right.
Just 3-4 colors. That's what I'm aiming for, bold colors, but still have a recognizable image.
Yeah, it is.
So I think minimalist is the key word.
Mm-hmm. I would say, I will add elegant. I think it's minimalistic and elegant, very elegant portraits.
Thank you.
And which artists are your main inspiration or influence?
There are a few. One of them is Noma Bar. And of course, there's Roy Lichtenstein and Keith Haring. Mm-hmm. You know, they all have these very graphic styles with simple colors, and yet they create very powerful images.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I love them too.
Yeah, Noma Bar is my favorite. It's minimalism and there's a message.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So, yeah.
Okay. And how long, on average, does it take you to complete complete an illustration?
Well, it depends. Depends on the image, the source image. Sometimes it's 20, maybe 30 minutes.
Oh, it's not too much. It's quite quick.
But there's, you know, I've got some experience now in leaving out stuff, and but you know, I also have a group image of the revolution, and it took me more than 2 weeks to complete.
Wow,
that's a very complex image. Wow. And I also have an image from the Love Sexy tour. Mm-hmm. It's called Mozart, and that he has these pens with all this. that's a crazy design, and that took me days as well.
Wow.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Talking about prints and Love Sexy era, do you have a favorite era when it comes to drawing prints?
Yeah, that's probably Love Sexy and Purple Rain, because they're both so colorful.
Yeah, and the textures, patterns, right?
Yeah, exactly. And then and the clothing, you know, that and the hair. There's so much going on.
Yeah. So much going on.
Yeah, a lot.
Okay, and from all your body of work, Marco, which is your favorite prints illustration?
I think that has to be Tiny Giant, the one I call Tiny Giant. It's where you see prints, just prints and a piano from behind. Mm-hmm. And you know, it shows its loneliness to me. And I think it's a very powerful image.
It is.
And I made it 5 years after April 21st, 16. So, and actually I it was so powerful to me, I could not create another one for 3 months.
Oh, it's so like, it
took a lot of energy. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, it's fantastic. It's very, very powerful and a little bit sad, because you can see how lonely he was in that period.
And yep, exactly.
It's amazing. It's very beautiful. So,
thank you.
So this illustration, Tiny Giant, is in your website, so people can see it there. But on your website, people can also purchase your prints, some books, and other merch. Mainly, I don't know, like prints or beans as well. And your website, if I'm not wrong, is 1999art.com, right?
Perfect. Exactly.
Okay. So could you tell me which is your best-selling illustration of prints?
It's Tiny Giant.
The same one.
It is, yes. Yeah, a lot of people seem to like it.
Yeah. It's very special. So whenever I see it, I feel like I want to be with Prince, like, you know, embracing him. Yeah. So it's a way of, I don't know, feeling him like very inside of you or something, like very personal.
Yes. Yeah.
So, yeah.
You also feel his fragility, you know, it's just, yeah. So
I was in Minneapolis last June during celebration, and I saw some of your prints projected in First Avenue's screen.
Yes. Yes.
During this Purple Hikes party, the Dance Electric. And I have to say that they really worked fantastic with all the music and the background, the environment, and yes, people just love them. So how did this collaboration happen?
I've seen the pictures, and I'm sorry I couldn't be there, but it was really special. Mm-hmm. You know, for my stuff to be that location. I'm mm-hmm. proud of that. How did it start? About a month before celebration, I got an email from DJ Dudley D, mm-hmm. who wrote me a message that he wanted to throw a party at First Avenue, and he asked me if it would be okay to display my art on a big screen.
And you said yes, of course.
Could not refuse.
It's like a dream, isn't it?
I mean, of course. And it's like First Avenue, or I think next step is Paisley Park. But after that...
Well, who knows? Who knows? Maybe.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Who knows?
You never know.
You never know. Yes, you never know. So have you ever been to the First Avenue, Minneapolis? I think so. You said that you were...
Yes.
Okay. So how did you feel in there?
Special. I mean, you know, it's not just about Prince, but there's so much musical history in that place. And it just feels special just to walk around and realize what happened there. You know, and then just...
I'm magical. There.
Yes. Mm-hmm. True. So, yeah, that's First Avenue, but that's Paisley Park as well. And most parts of Minneapolis, there's a lot of history.
It is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Marco, you have also illustrated book covers, mm-hmm. some Purple events, posters. Could you just make a summary of your most important projects so our audience knows about them?
Two book covers I do know are Continued Thanks and a book, The Life of Prince and the Places to See by Kenneth from Denmark.
I know that one, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I've made some posters. I've made some logos for Paisley 5 and 9.
All right.
I didn't keep a list of all the things, but, you know, I'm glad sometimes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's out there, and I'm glad sometimes people just know to find me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe you can work with us in the future for Purple Music Magazine or an event, who knows?
I'd be happy to.
and we would be happy to. Okay, and do you have any future projects regarding the Purple World?
Well, first of all, I'm coming to Madrid in November.
Yeah!
Well, I'm planning a new book for next year. Mm-hmm. It's called Bridge.
Bridge. Oh, sorry? Bridge. All right.
Bridge,
So around Graffiti Bridge era, I guess.
Yeah. So if you know my Moon and Rain books,
yeah,
I think you get an idea what this will be about.
Sure.
So it's probably mid next year.
Okay. We will be looking forward to seeing it.
Yeah.
And talking about Prince, you are a fan. So how did you become a Prince fan?
Long time ago. There was a guy in my school, in my class, and he asked me, what do you think of Prince? Who's Prince? And he said, okay, I will call you when it's on television again. And next day he called me, and there was When Doves Cry video. Mm-hmm. That was my first time to see Prince, and the rest is history, I guess. That's where it happens. Yeah, it's when I was crying after that, the Purple Rain album came out, and
So it
meantime,
was at that period. So you were living at the same time that everything was happening, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so it had to be very exciting to live all that period, being a young man, boy.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, I mean, I was 13, 14, you know, being so young and then get all this stuff coming at you. And another album, and next year another album, and Around the World, and Parade, and Sign of the Times, and Love Sexy. It's just, there's so much going on, and the concerts and all. Yeah.
Fantasy, yes.
It's exciting, really exciting.
Very exciting period, yes.
Yeah.
And what's your favorite album or era?
Oh,
you can say many if you have many.
Sorry?
You can say many.
Yeah, that of course there are many, but I think it would be Sign of the Times, but like most people, and I really like the Gold Experience.
Oh,
yeah, Gold Experience is one of my favorites.
Very powerful period for Prince too.
It was, and also with the MPG albums,
Exodus,
and all this, some very good songs there.
Yeah, it's one of my favorites too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And how many times have you seen Prince live? And if you have seen him many times, which was the most special?
If I count it right, 49 times.
Oh my god.
And but
49.
You know, in the 80s he was all over Europe every year. So it was easy to just follow them around Europe and go to Holland.
Well,
and go
if
to
you Belgium. If you lived in the Netherlands, it was easy. If you lived in Spain, not so easy.
I know, I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. So yeah, it was around about 49, and most special, I can't say. It could be my first show, it could be my first after show, could be my last show,
right?
It could be the first show where I was in the front row, you know. It could be, there's so many. it's very difficult.
Yeah, but I'm curious, Marco, which was the first one that you attended?
In Rotterdam, August 86.
Parade. Oh.
Yes.
Amazing tour, yeah. And which was the last one?
Last one was 2014 in Antwerp, Belgium.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Was my last one.
Was that with Threger?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And which was the first one in first row?
Oh boy.
If you remember.
Probably, yeah. Must have been one of the Love Sexy shows in Rotterdam.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I'm so jealous right now.
Don't be.
Well, I'm very happy for you.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, is there any particular show that you would have liked to attend and you couldn't?
Yeah, all the other shows I didn't see.
Well, you saw Prince 49 times, so, you know.
Well, you know, something I would have loved to see was the very first show at the Capri.
Oh, right, yeah.
You know, or Amsterdam 1981.
Mm-hmm.
Or some after shows, or the piano and microphone show in Minneapolis, in Paisley Park. Too many.
I'm
thankful for the shows I did see. So,
of course, I think we all have to, even if you have seen Prince just once, it's something very special. So. We have been
absolutely
very fortunate, very lucky to live in the same period as Prince, right?
Mm-hmm. Right. Privilege.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm curious, did you have the chance to attend the after show in Den Haag, I think is the name, a small club.
No, I didn't. And stupid enough, at that time, I didn't know about the existence of after shows.
Okay.
So it was only the next day I read in the newspaper what happened. And I was like, oh, okay. Surprise.
Yeah. It happened to me as well in Barcelona. So, yeah.
Oh, really?
It was like, oh my God, yes, he did it. And I wasn't there.
But, you know, after that, of course, it was it's a learning curve. And after that, during every show, you have your antennas out, like, do I hear anything about aftershow? So just
to be aware.
You see people talking, you try to hear what it's about because,
The Prince fans are a little bit crazy, aren't we? Like, we were like, oh my God, like buying the tickets, running to first row, trying to find if there is going to be an aftershow. So,
Yes, exactly. A little bit crazy.
But yeah, but fun. Crazy, but fun.
Yeah.
Okay. There are three compulsory questions generally in our shows for our guests.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm going to start with the first one, which is, could you tell me a Prince song that you consider that is undervalued or underrated?
Probably If I Was Your Girlfriend.
Oh. Do you think so?
I think so, because you don't hear it on the radio too often, but it's a beautiful song, and it's there's so much going on there. I love it. Yes. Yeah. It's one of my favorites.
I think it's a gem for fans, but it's not so well known for the rest of the world.
Right.
So,
yeah,
a beautiful song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is.
Okay, and now we're going to talk about the opposite. A Prince song that you think that is overrated or overvalued.
Oh, this is difficult. People are going to hate me now.
I know, but we all have done this before, so now it's your turn.
Okay. Do Me Baby.
Do Me Baby. Oh, wow. Yeah. Why?
Yeah, I just don't like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you never know when it comes to tastes, so yes.
It's difficult. I did hear one version, one live version, which I liked, but in general, it's, you know, when the album's on, I skip that song. It's one of the few songs I skip.
Okay, well... we all have one. I have Adore, and people hate me for that.
Adore. So. Oh, yeah. For me, it's usually the slower songs that I don't like that much. Yeah.
So you are more like a funk man, right?
Yeah.
You like to funk.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. This just sounds like Billy Jack Bitch or, you know, just... Yeah.
The Exodus area... the Exodus right. period is... It's a very powerful, very danceable and funk. So
mm-hmm.
I agree with you.
Okay.
And the last question is a Prince song that you consider your guilty pleasure. And you have to be brave in here.
Maybe Dinner with Dolores.
Oh,
that's a
good
one.
Well, but Dinner with Dolores, I would say it's a good guilty pleasure. why do you like this song?
It sounds so simple.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's very easy to the ear. Mm-hmm. It's just always fun to listen to.
Okay, to just enjoy it.
I just enjoy it, and the same with Do You Lie. It's just like a children's song or just happy.
Okay.
Sounds happy. Yeah.
Okay. Before we finish, Marco, in every show, we ask our guest to ask a question to the next guest without knowing who this will be.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to think on a question, but before that, you need to answer the one from our previous guest, who was a collector and curator from Minneapolis, Rich A. Benson. I think you know him.
Hey, Rich. Yeah, I do.
Hello, Rich. Okay, so the question he asked was the next one. How long do you think Prince spent in front of the mirror before a show or tour, you know, with his makeup, the hair, the clothes, and so on?
Wow. I don't have much experience with makeup, so, but I think he probably got quite a routine in doing that, but maybe still 30 to 45 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Could be. I don't know. He was a perfectionist. I don't think he would be ready in 15 minutes. So,
no.
Yeah.
But maybe he had like the experience of doing it each and every day, so maybe he was fast. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. And then, of course, the costume changes during the show, they had to be quick, so couldn't be much time. But, you know, I think makeup, yeah. Maybe he got his routine and he got faster. But,
yeah. I remember when we talked with Maite Garcia, she said that during the Act 2 tour, do you remember that... While My Name is Prince, she went in the stage and she pretended she was Prince.
Mm-hmm.
And she said that while she was in the stage, Prince was with a mic, with a microphone on, like, My Name is Prince, and doing his makeup.
Oh, really?
Yes, it was really, really fun.
That was funny. Yeah.
Okay, so have you thought your question for the next guest?
Yeah, you know, I think it is difficult to like and love and adore everything an artist does, even if it's Prince. And I'm wondering for the next guest, you know, it's good to be a critic sometimes. Is there something or anything that you as a Prince fan wish he had not done or said or recorded?
Okay.
Or really?
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see. Good question.
Curious.
So we will ask this question to the next guest. I don't know who this will be. So
okay, no, good luck.
Okay, before we leave, Marco, please remind our audience where they can follow you and purchase your prints or merchandising on the internet.
Okay, well, my website is 1999art.com. So that's a number 9, letter T, number 9. And it's also on Facebook. It's 1999art. Same on Instagram and X.
Okay.
Formerly Twitter.
So everyone follow Marco because his art is beautiful. Beautiful. I'm in love with your work.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
No, that's a pleasure. Thank you very, very much for being with me today.
Me too.
It's been an honor and a pleasure to finally speak with you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for giving me the opportunity.
Well, I think it's very important. Yeah. This is why we do this section, to show the world what Prince fans are doing to keep the legacy alive. Mm-hmm. And you are doing a fantastic job. So thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.
And see you in a few weeks in Madrid, just 3 weeks.
Looking forward to it. Beautiful.
Yeah, me too.
Okay.
Thank you, Marco. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.